Okay, so in this episode, I'm going to show you how to make some shape layer accents. You may have seen some of these packs out there, either from companies or from individuals. So what I was thinking is I could show you how to make these on your own. And so this will be the first episode in a series. And eventually, I would like to build up a shape layer accent library. So let's go ahead and get started. Right click in this area to the left of your timeline. We're going to create a shape layer. And we're going to call this one animated circles. Okay, so let's go ahead and open that up. And then we want to add in a group. And we're just going to call this O1. Inside that group, let's add in an ellipse. I'm going to give that ellipse a stroke. Okay, so let's go ahead and increase the size of our ellipse. Maybe give our stroke a little bit of size to it. And then we want to add in a trim paths. Okay, so let's open up that trim paths and put keyframes at the beginning of our animation here. Set these both to 0. Shift page down twice to go for 20 frames and make these both 100. Okay, we can select those. F9 to make those Bezier. Then let's just offset these a little bit. Spread these out however you'd like to get the speed that you're looking for. I'm going to close up that and open up our stroke settings. I'm going to change this to a round cap. I'm going to add in some expression controls directly onto our shape layer. If everything is on one layer, we can save this as an animation preset, and you'll see the value of this here in just a bit. First, let's add in a checkbox control, and we're going to call this direction. Then I'll add in a color control, and I'm going to go ahead and make this white for now. Two slider controls. So we're going to call the first one stroke width, and the second one we're going to call size. So now we're going to have three of these. So we'll make this direction one. And just for sake of consistency, I'm going to go up or lower. Color control one, stroke width one, and size one. Ellipse path size right here. This is going to be what's connected to our size one. So we can see we are at, we'll say 200. I'm going to go ahead and make my size one 200 so that way it's consistent. Link that up, and as you can see, you can adjust this and it will adjust the size of your ellipse. Let's go into our stroke, and we can grab our stroke width right here, and we're going to link that to our stroke width, and I believe we had that. We can try 30. For our color right here, we want to link this over to our color. This direction thing, this is really one of the big parts of this tutorial, I think, is very cool. We're going to add in an expression that's going to control basically this right here, the direction of this animation. As you can see, it comes in and goes to the right. So the way that we're going to affect that is to use the group's opacity setting. Option click onto opacity, and we want to type this expression, direction equals, and then take your pick whip for your expression control and go up to this checkbox. Hit return. If direction, two equal signs, one, and the way checkbox controls work is 0 is off, 1 is on. So we're saying if this checkbox is 1, then we want this value to be 100. And since it's on the opacity, that means we want it to be on. So that way we can see it. Else, we want this to be 0. And we're going to use the curly brackets for that. So direction equals, and then you can pick whip that checkbox. If direction, double equal signs, 100 inside of curly brackets, else 0 inside of curly brackets. We can see that it disappeared. Now, if we click it back on, it will come back on. So we're going to come back to this here in just a little bit. This expression is very important. Okay, so let's close that up and let's duplicate O1. I'm going to pull this underneath. If we hit EE, this brings up our expressions. So we're looking for everything starting from transform 2. We want to link that up to its own properties over here. Select all of these controls here, control D to duplicate, and we can bring these underneath. So now we have direction 2, color control 2, stroke width 2, and size 2. Go in here and change this 1 to a 2. Change our stroke width 1 to a 2. Change our color control 1 to a 2. And then our size to a 2. So now we can use these controls over here for this second animation. So I'm going to increase my size a little bit. You can see it grow right there. Maybe we'll bring our stroke width from 30, maybe down to 25, or maybe we'll say 20. We can change this color. It's like a light green. We're gonna leave this direction alone for now. Let's select the layer and hit U to bring up our keyframes. So this is our second animation right here. I just want to offset this by 3 or 4 frames. And now we want to do one more. So let's take from direction 2 to size 2, duplicate that, bring this underneath, and now we have direction 3, color control 3, stroke width 3, and size 3. So I'm going to go ahead and change some of these settings. So let's change this size from 300, 350, and these are all going to change in just a second. I just wanted to kind of make some of these settings a little bit more random so you have an idea of how this is going to look. Okay, so now let's open this back up, and we can take our second group here. Duplicate that. So now we have 3. We'll bring 3 underneath 2. EE to bring up our expressions. And again, we're looking for starting at transform 3. We're going to change all of these 2s to 3. So that way they will link up to the expression controls that correspond with this group. Okay, color control, we'll say 3. And size 3. Okay, so select a layer. Hit U to bring up our keyframes. And let's take these last set of keyframes. This is the animation that we have, which is something that you may have seen. It looks kind of cool. And now I want to show you how we can alter the direction of this. So that way you can choose which direction you want to go in. We can see this path direction right here. This is linked to our ellipse path. So with that layer selected, all you have to do is come up here and type path. And now we see we have these directions here. If you hover over it, you can see that it says reverse path direction. So that's what we're going to be focused on. So let's open this back up, go to contents, add a group. And now all of these right now animate to the right. So now the expression that we have on our opacity, remember, if direction equals 1, meaning the checkbox is selected, this opacity will be 100. So we need to make these shapes go in the opposite direction and then adjust the opacity. And I'll show you how to do that real quick. Take right and we'll duplicate that. We're going to call this left. And then let's just select this layer, go to our finder, and let's type opacity because we're looking for the opacity of all of these layers. So we want to look for opacity for the left. So these three groups here, 1, 2, and 3, and now reverse these values. So what we want to say is if the direction equals 1, we want it to turn off. We'll make this 0 and we'll make this value 100. If the checkbox is on, we want this layer to be off. Otherwise, it will be turned on. We'll make that 0, else 100, and this final one, 0, and then else 100. Type in path. Under our left group, we want these to go in the opposite direction. So all of these go in the opposite direction. If we uncheck direction 2, that will now go in the opposite direction. And if you're wondering what the point of doing all this is now, I will show you. Let's close all of this up. Select contents, effect, and transform. There's this little icon right here. It's on your effects and presets for create new animation. You can also go up to animation, save animation preset. Documents, Adobe, the version we're using, 2023 is what I'm on. User presets, and I'm going to put this in my 7-minute AE folder. Add a folder. I'm going to call it shape layer accent library because this is going to be the first of many that I want to create. Call this animated circles. Okay, and if we hit save, now we can get rid of that shape layer, come over to effects and presets and type in animated circles, and we can see it's right here. So let's just double click that. And as we can see, everything came back in. So now this can be dropped in with a click of a button, quite literally. You have all the controls that we already created. You can stack this if you'd like in other animations. So if you want to duplicate that, bring up your scale, you can bring this up. And now these have their own sets of controls. So see, if we click this layer, these are the controls for that. This new layer has its own set of controls. So you can adjust the color on this. Maybe you want to make the stroke width a different size as it gets larger. You can offset this. This can be added in to any number of projects as just a shape layer accent, something that may be kind of cool to include in an infographic or something like that. I see these shape layer accent packs all over the place and people charge money for them. I think it's a good idea to learn how to do this from scratch, learn some very basic expressions, learn some tools like this, because you can apply that in a number of different situations. This is the first of many that I would like to do. Let me know in the comments if this is something that you'd be interested in, if you'd like to see more of this, and thanks for watching. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.